interrogate people and to learn how to protect their own agents against control by others. If you put someone in a position of being disabled by not feeding them or not allowing them to sleep or overwhelming them with sound, if you use massive shock treatment and you give people massive doses of drugs such as PCP or mescaline or amphetamines or LSD, and if you put them in periods of darkness where they can't predict from one minute to another what is going to happen next, so they're always dreading, there's no consistency to sort of what's going to happen, anybody can be put in a position of being open to brainwashing. Ewan Cameron was probably the foremost psychiatrist of his time in the 1950s. He was using high-tech sound techniques. He was using multiple kinds of loop recorders to force people to listen to recorded messages 24 hours a day for weeks on end to basically destroy people's thinking patterns.
Lysergic acid into the vein, and he patted me on the shoulder and said, "Now there, lassie, we'll see you later." And I started to feel very frightened, and the fright became a terror. And I sort of began throwing myself from one side of the room to the other. I didn't know what to do to stop this feeling. It felt like my bones were melting. That I just didn't know who I was anymore.
This is not just break-ins of people's homes. It's not just invasions of privacy by illegal wiretapping. This is an invasion of a person's mind. But that is about as profound an injury, except for loss of life, that the government can impose.
This was a post-Nazi program, if you will. It was an Americanization.
I've often made a statement, and I still make it flippantly. The Nazis didn't lose the war. They just had to move.
Now it's 50 years later. Now they're much more clever, much more sophisticated. They have a lot more money to spend.
Many people believe public relations is press agentry, flackery, publicity. Public relations is not that. It is a two-way street, advising the client on attitudes and actions to win over the public on whom viability of the unit depends, and then educating, informing, and persuading the public to accept these social goods, ideas, concepts, or whatever.
Someone to give me a good hard slap in the face.
How's that?
Good.
If you need any help with the other cheek, let me know. I'm right here.
Well, it's Groundhog Day. Again? And that must mean we're up here at Gobbler's Knob.
Because I sure as heck fire remember you. It's me, Ned Ryerson. Needle-nosed, dead-head, the head. Come on, buddy. Case, what's your name? Hey! Hey!
Bill! Bill! Over
you about a matter that's not work-related?
You never talk about work.
We really have to talk. Come on.
Hey!
It's a creative meeting. Forget it.
Wait a second. We've got work to do.
No, I don't. I've already done it twice. Skim milk to sugar.
Yeah,
thanks, Phil. Basic drink.
We're just setting up.
Pastry, Larry. Take your pick.
Thanks, Phil.
Raspberry. Great. See, I was just talking with Buster Green. He's the head groundhog honcho. And he said, if you set up over here, we might get a better shot. What do you think?
Sounds good.
All right, what do you think?
Yeah, let's go for it.
It worked, Phil.
Maybe we'll get lucky. Let me give you a hand with a heavy stick. No, that's your problem. We never talk, Larry. Do you have kids?
Many people believe public relations is press agency, flackery, publicity. Public relations is not that. It is a two-way street, advising the client on attitudes and actions to win over the public on whom viability of the unit depends, and then educating, informing, and persuading the public to accept these social goods, ideas, concepts.
It's
mine
for the truth. It's mine for the truth. It's mine for the truth. You know, the way things look isn't always what they seem. The meaning of things can be different to what they look like. Hi, I'm Dr. Andy Warhola, and I got a PhD in sensitivity in the arts. We've just been looking at a portrait of the author George Orwell by the Australian artist Andy P. I buried the base deep into the structure and changed a few things. Yeah, right. It's a psychological nightmare. Very interesting. Thanks. The thing is, before I told you the name of the artwork, you had no idea that it was actually a face.
In many ways, it's about all the other things you might think about. Not necessarily about anything particular.
Might have thought it was some mountains, or some strange architecture, or a new city, or perhaps something to do with sensations. These days, we are more and more unable to say what things are.